absolute value inequalities less than. The absolute value of x less than 2 means that the distance from 0 is less than 2. Now, if we have a graph right here, this graph is of a compound and inequality. And it can be written as x is greater than negative 2 and x is less than 2. So if the absolute value is less than a number, we set up an AND equation. One of the things you may notice is that this graph, the two inequalities are going toward each other. With an OR, they're going in opposite directions. And we'll always get that with an absolute value inequality. Let's take a look at our two examples. In example one, we have the absolute value of 3x plus 7 is less than 6. So when we set this up to solve, we have 3x plus 7 is less than 6 for our one equation. And for our other, we have 3x plus 7. Remember, we're multiplying by a negative, so we're flipping the inequality, and it'll be greater than negative 6. So let's solve the first equation by subtracting negative 7 from both sides. We have 3x is less than negative 1, divide by 3, and we get x is less than negative 1/3. Solving our other equation, again, we'll divide or multiply. How about add a negative 7? And we get 3x is greater than negative 13. Divide by 3, and x is greater than negative 13/3. So on our graph, we've got negative 13/3 is down here. Negative 1/3 is here. And it says that x is less than negative 1/3, so we'll have an open dot at negative 1/3. X is greater than negative 13/3, we'll have an open dot there. And our graph will go in between those two numbers. Then our inequality solution set with interval notation will be parentheses negative 13/3, comma negative 1/3, parentheses. Let's take a look at example two. We set up the first equation exactly as it's written, with 4x plus 1 is less than or equal to 2. Our second equation, we have 4x plus 1 will be greater than or equal to a negative 2. Don't forget to flip the inequality. Subtract 1 from both sides. We get 4x is less than or equal to 1. Divide by 4. And we get that x is less than or equal to 1/4. Subtract 1 from both sides. We have 4x is greater than or equal to negative 3. Divide by 4. We get x is greater than or equal to negative 3/4. So on our graph, we have negative 3/4 down here and 1/4 up here. We're going to have closed dots on here because of the equal sign. That's the other thing here to keep in mind is that your dots are going to be the same. They're either going to be both closed or going to be both open. We're not going to have anything, they will not be different, I guess is the best way to say that. We have x is less than or equal to 1/4 and greater than or equal to negative 3/4. And so there's our graph. Our interval notation then will be from, we want a bracket because we have a closed dot. So it'll be from negative 3/4 to 1/4 and a bracket closing that.